Hi, I'm Tripti Singh. I work at the Center for Policy Research, and today I'm going to talk on what the law says on manual scavenging. The nature of manual scavenging has evolved in relation to changes in sanitation technologies in the country. In the traditional sense, it was understood as the practice of cleaning dry toilets manually or with the aid of tin scrapers, brooms, cane baskets, metal buckets. It was referred to as the removal of night soil or carrying of night soil as head loads. More recently, cleaning of sewers, septic tank has also been understood as manual scavenging or is referred as hazardous cleaning. However, what remains constant through the decades, despite all these changes, is that manual scavenging and manual scavengers continue to come from castes, subcastes that are customarily relegated to the bottom of the hierarchy. This caste-based occupation reinforces the social stigma that these people are unclean, they are impure, and they are untouchable. Discrimination extends to all facets of their lives to the extent that their rules of purity and pollution governs their everyday interactions. They're referred as Dalits, Bhangis, Valmikis. These terms are used almost as an occupational descriptive term for manual scavengers, and this extends to all religions. For instance, this term is applied to Muslims, to neo-Buddhist, even Christian scavenging communities. If we look at the historical context, right from the independence, we see that there has been a thrust on manual scavenging, and this thrust is from a human rights perspective. For instance, right from independence in late 1940s to about 1970s, the focus was on understanding the living and working condition of manual scavengers. It was only in the 1980s that the government pushed for a technological solution wherein they introduced the integrated low-cost sanitation scheme. According to this scheme, there was a thrust towards conversion of dry latrines to pore flush latrines. In 1993, the first law on manual scavenging was introduced. It prohibited the construction of dry latrines on one hand, and on the other hand, it prohibited the employment of manual scavengers. However, this act was not applicable to all states at one go. States had to notify it, and subsequently, as a result of it, states were not forthcoming in applying it in the first instance. In the same year, 1993, the NSLRS, which is the Scheme for National Liberation and Rehabilitation of Manual Scavengers, was introduced. Under this scheme, there was provisions made for rehabilitation of manual scavengers. Recognizing the changes in the sanitation scape, two decades later, a new Manual Scavenging Act was reintroduced in 2013. Under this act, the definition of manual scavenging was broadened to include all those who manually clean or dispose human excreta from insanitary latrines or from open drain or from railway tracks. This was a central law. It was applicable all at once to the entire country. Subsequently, in 2014, the Swachh Bharat Mission was introduced with a strong thrust towards construction of toilet across the country. According to the 2011 census, there is a high reliance on on-site sanitation system, both in urban and rural areas. So as part of the government push towards toilet construction through SPM and expansion of sewer networks through Amrut scheme, there are more and more toilets that have been created that are connected to either on-site sanitation system or to sewer systems. So this problem of hazardous cleaning becomes extremely critical at this point. And if steps under the Act, the new Act, if they are not implemented, then it can become even more problematic for the workers. The strength of the new Act is that it brings hazardous cleaning of sewers and septic tank under its ambit. While the 93 Act focused on preventing the construction of dry latrines, the new Act focuses on insanitary latrines. It prohibits its construction. It places restriction on manual cleaning of sewers and septic tanks in order to protect workers involved in these activities. There's a strong thrust on using safety devices and safety gear under the Act. There are about 44 safety gears that have been listed under the rule. It places the onus on the employer to provide these cares. Non-compliance with these restrictions is viewed as an offense. Even in cases when cleaning does not result in death or an injury, it would be termed as an offense. The penal consequences under the new Act are more stringent. For instance, if we compare 93 Act with the 2013 Act, under the 93 Act, it was envisaged that the failure to comply with the rules would be seen as an offense, which would result into punishment of about a year and a fine of rupees 2000. In contrast to this, under the new Act, a maximum punishment of up to 2 years and a fine of about 2 lakhs is imposed on the offender for the first offense. And for any other offense after that, 5 years of imprisonment would be levied with a fine of rupees 5 lakhs. District magistrate is the apex authority for implementing the Act. After that, there are 3 levels of monitoring committee. One is at the district level, which is the district vigilance committee, followed by the state monitoring committee, and then the central monitoring committee. On the top of it is the National Commission for Safai Karamchari, who is supposed to implement the Act in totality. While there are these committees and commissions in place to implement the Act, still manual scavenging deaths and manual cleaning of sewers and septic tank continue in our country. According to NCSK, between 1993 to 2019, 814 sewer deaths have been reported across 20 states, of which Tamil Nadu reported one of the highest number of deaths, which is about 206, followed by Gujarat and then Uttar Pradesh. In a little over 2 years, that is from say April 2017 to about June 2019, 88 people have died across 13 states and UTs, of which 18 deaths took place in Delhi itself, which is the national capital and with more powers at the authority level to implement the Act effectively. While Manual Scavenging Act 2013 exists, the implementation of the Act has been extremely weak. Despite these deaths, Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, in a response to a Lok Sabha question recently, said that no conviction has happened or taken place across any of the states or UTs in the entire country. So to conclude, I would say that one of the key critical areas is to strengthen accountability for states to ensure that the implementation of Act, the new Act 2013, takes place properly. It places the onus on the employer to provide protective and safety gears. Workers continue to engage in hazardous cleaning that lead to serious injury or result in death. There has been no conviction in such cases, like I mentioned. So it needs to be applied on the ground with more stringent clauses. Access to safety devices and protective gear is a critical problem. One size fits all strategy cannot work. Therefore, protective gears have to be designed in a way so that they're suitable to both climatic condition as well as to the physical build of the worker themselves, to ensure that it's taken up by the workers. Most of sewer cleaning work is outsourced either to private organization, by government, or it's done through subcontracting. Therefore, the process of subcontracting needs to be regulated to ensure that the chosen organization provides safe working environment to its workers by providing safety equipments, protective gear, in order to ensure their safety. While the state has provided various measures to rehabilitate manual scavengers, yet we notice that there is a tendency to slip back into manual scavenging. And there are various factors that are reasons for this. They take up loans which they're not able to pay back, or they're not trained or don't have a history of being entrepreneurs. These are some of the factors that lead to the slip back into old professions. Even those who give up manual scavenging, they continue to do so part-time. So we need a rehabilitation plan that is effective and it works for them, and it has to be designed with them. With this, I'll close today's conversation. However, all outputs, research work that we're doing at Center for Policy Research, at the Scaling City Institution for India Sanitation Initiative, we'll keep putting it out. Thanks for watching the video, and we look forward to seeing you also in some of our conferences.